Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel with another video on the chapter lens. Today we are going to study the sign conventions of a lens, which is very important from the exam point of view. So to study the or to do the numericals related to this topic, that the sign convention, basically you have to know 5 rules. In your book there are 6 rules, but I have summarized it to 5 rules. So basically you have to know what are these 5 rules, and from these 5 rules, if you know it by heart, then I think you can do any sums related to this topic. And yeah, in board one question in section B is definitely going to come of 4 marks from this topic, because in every year it comes. So to start with the chapter, we have to basically know the 5 rules related to this sign convention. So 5 rules that you have to know. 5 rules. So first rule is what? The first rule says that the optical center is taken as the origin. The optical center is taken as the origin. Means what? If I have the 2 lens, this is a convex lens and this is a concave lens, you all know that this is the optical center. This is the optical center. Now in your maths you have done lot of graphs, and in a graph you have the coordinate axis, right? This is called the x-axis, this is called the y-axis, and the point where both the axes meet is called as the origin, with 0 and 0 coordinate. The 0 x coordinate and the 0 y coordinate. Okay, you say abscissa and ordinate like that. So this origin is taken as the optical center is taken as the origin. So the basic thing that you have to know is that over here is what? The optical center is taken as the origin. So this is the first rule. I hope you don't have any problem in understanding the first rule, which is very simple. Now coming to the second rule. The second rule states that the object is placed on the left hand side of the lens. The object is placed on the left hand side of the lens. Means what? If I have to show you by a diagram, again, this is a convex, this is a concave, and this is the optical center. All the object that we always place, that is placed on the left hand side, very important, on the left hand side. So I think you know this is your right hand side and this is your left hand side. So my left hand side is over here. So this is the object, and you can see the object is placed on the left hand side. You can see, so object is placed on the left hand side. This is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. So the object is placed on the left hand side of the lens. So this is the second rule, which is also very simple from my point of view. There is nothing much to understand, that object is placed on the left hand side. The third rule. The third rule states, all distances are measured along the principal axis from the optical center. The third rule says, all distances आर मेजर्ड अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस फ्रॉम द ऑरिजिन. यू हैव टू नो दिस रूल. सो ऑल डिस्टेंस आर मेजर्ड अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस फ्रॉम द ऑरिजिन. मीन्स वॉट? इफ आई टेक दिस एज माई कॉन्वेक्स लेंस एंड दिस एज माई कॉन्वेक्स लेंस, सो वॉट द रूल सेज, ऑल द डिस्टेंसेज, सपोज आई टेक माई ऑब्जेक्ट इज ओवर हेयर, यू नो द ऑब्जेक्ट इज ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, और यू कैन से माई इमेज इज ओवर हेयर, ओवर देयर ऑल्सो यू कैन से. सो एज आई वॉज सेइंग, माई ऑब्जेक्ट इज ओवर हेयर एंड द इमेज इज ओवर हेयर, एंड वेर इज माई ऑप्टिकल सेंटर, सपोज ओवर हेयर, ऑप्टिकल सेंटर इज ओवर हेयर. सो आई विल मेजर माई डिस्टेंसेज फ्रॉम द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ओवर हेयर, आई हैव टू मेजर द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द ऑरिजिन और फ्रॉम द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर. ओके, सो आई थ्रो टू, सो दिस इज माई स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट. सो फ्रॉम द ऑरिजिन और फ्रॉम द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर मीन्स वॉट? दिस बिकम्स द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट, एंड आई हैव टू मेजर द डिस्टेंस अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. सो अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस मीन्स वॉट? आई हैव टू गो अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस लाइक दिस वे. सो यू कैन सी, यू हैव, सो दिस बिकम्स माई ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस. इफ हैव टू मेजर द इमेज, आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर, नॉट फ्रॉम द इमेज to the optical center. Oh, that is wrong. If you are going in, suppose you are measuring this distance like this way, from the image to the optical center, this is wrong. This is basically wrong. So what you have to, what is the rule says? The rule says that you have to measure it from the optical center to the image. So the rule says you have to measure it from the optical center, from the optical center to the image. So this is what the rule says. Similarly over here, if you are doing, suppose this is my object and this is my image. So the rule says what? You have to measure it from the optical center. We know this is the optical center. So the rule says you have to measure it along the optical center. From the optical center along the principal axis. So to measure the distance like this way. This is my image distance and this is my object distance. So I think you got the point. So all distances are measured from the principal axis, along the principal axis, from the origin. So from the starting point has to be origin or the optical center. I think you understood this point. Over here only I am saying, there are some denotation. Okay, so like object distance is always denoted by the letter U. Image distance is always denoted by the letter V. And focal length is denoted by the letter F. So suppose this is my object, so I will denote this by U. This is my image distance, I will denote this by V. Again over here, this one is my image distance, so I will denote this by V. This is my object distance, I will denote this by U. So object distance and image distance are denoted by U and V respectively. You have to remember, object distance is denoted by U, image distance is denoted by V, and focal length is F. That is, I think that is understood very clearly, because from the mirror chapter you are doing focal length as F. So I think the third rule is very much clear to you. The third rule is very okay to understand. Now the fourth rule and fifth rule, these are the two most important rule out of the five rules. So fourth rule and fifth rule are very important rules. So the fourth rule says what? The distance which is measured along the direction of incident ray is taken as positive, and the distances which are measured opposite to the incident ray is taken as negative. And this is very important. All distances measured in the direction of incident ray is taken as positive. Okay, and the second point related to this is what? All the distances measured in the direction opposite to the incident ray is taken as negative. So important things: measured in the direction of incident ray is taken as positive. Distances measured in the direction opposite to the incident ray, is taken as negative. These few lines are very important to understand. Direction in the incident ray positive, direction opposite to the incident ray is taken as negative. And to explain this, I'll use some diagrams. Suppose I take a concave lens, convex lens. In a convex lens, this is my optical center. Suppose here is my object, and suppose here is my image. Okay, so I'll put a this way, okay, a dotted line to make you understand this is actually image. Now this is denoted, suppose this distance is denoted by a length, say 20 centimeter, and say this is say 30 centimeter. So I can say what? My u is 20 centimeter and my v is 30 centimeter. But over here the trick is positive and negative you have to understand. So what is the direction of incident ray? My direction of incident ray is along this way. This is the arrow. This is the direction of incident ray. So this is the direction of incident ray. So this is my direction of incident ray. I hope you understand. This is the direction of my incident ray, this green arrow. Now, if you are measuring this object distance, okay, this is the object distance we are measuring, which is 20 centimeter. How you are going to measure it? How you are supposed to measure it? You have to measure it from the optical center. Because the previous rule says that only. From the optical center along the principal axis. You have to measure it in this way. Now you think, this is my direction of incident ray, and this is the direction where I am measuring my object distance. This is the direction how I am measuring my object distance. Are both are in the same direction or opposite direction? You can clearly see they are in the opposite direction. This green arrow and the blue arrow are in the opposite direction. And since they are in the opposite direction, this distance is taken as negative. So this 20 centimeter will be what? This 20 centimeter will be minus. So minus 20 centimeter. Understood? So this distance is taken as negative 20 centimeter. Now, if I have to measure this image distance also, I told you, have to be measured from the optical center to the image everywhere. The starting point is always optical center. I'm saying that. Okay, so if I have to measure this image distance, I have to start from the optical center and go towards the image. Now you see the direction of this green arrow and the direction of this red arrow. The direction of the green arrow and the direction of the red arrow are in the same way, are in the same direction. As they are in the same direction, this distance is taken as positive. So this will be what? This will be plus 30. So this will be plus 30 centimeters. So this is negative 20 centimeters and this is positive. I hope you are able to understand why this is negative and why this is positive. Because this is opposite to the direction of incident ray. Incident ray is always like this, from the left hand side to the right hand side. This never changes. This green arrow never changes. Now, when we are measuring the object distance, we are going opposite to the incident ray. When we are measuring the image distance, we are going with the incident ray. That is why with the incident ray positive, opposite to the incident ray negative. Now in this point only, I will put the sixth point and see how I am putting it. See, I hope you understood this, what I am trying to say. Now, this is my convex mirror lens, sorry, convex lens. And this is my concave lens. Now, all the previous videos, if you have watched my previous videos, I told you F2 is always considered as the focus, not F1, F2. So where is the F2 over here? For the convex lens, my F2 is on the right hand side. And for the concave, F2 is on the left hand side. Here is my F2. I think you understand. Previous videos always I explained, and F2 is always considered as the focus, not F1. Now, if I am measuring this focal distance, so I will start from the optical center and go towards the F2. You see this distance, focal distance, which is say denoted by F. This will be, this focal distance and the incident ray are in the same direction. You see this green arrow and this red arrow are in the same direction. So as they are in the same direction, this will be taken, this focal distance is taken as positive. So focal length for a convex lens is always positive. Suppose this length is 5 cm, so I'll write this as plus 5 cm, or only if you write only 5 cm, that is also okay. So focal length for a convex lens is taken as positive. Now you come in this diagram. In this diagram, you can clearly see, if I have to take the focal length, I'll have to start from the optical center and go towards the focus. Now, my incident ray and focal length are in the what? Are in the opposite direction. You can see my incident ray and the focal length are in the opposite direction. As they are in the opposite direction, so this focal length is taken as negative. This focal length is taken as negative. So this will be how much? This will be minus 5 centimeter. So suppose this is say 5 centimeter. But when we denote the focal length, that will be denoted as minus 5. So from here, very important things, when you will be doing the sums, over there it will be stated, concave lens, if it is a concave lens, the focus you have to take will be always negative. If it is mentioned convex lens, for the focal lens you have to take that as positive. So this is very important, that the concave, the focal length is negative. For a convex, the focal length is positive. This is fourth number point, which is very, very important. Now coming to point number 5, I hope point number 4 is clear to you. If it's not clear, please rewind the video a little 5-10 minutes earlier back and watch this part once more. I think if you watch it twice, it will be clear to you. Now point number 5. Okay, now point number 5. Point number 5 says that the length above the principal axis is taken as positive. The length above the principal axis is taken as positive, okay, writing nicely, is taken as positive, the length below the principal axis is taken as negative. So these two points is very important. So over here you have to know above the principal axis is positive and below the principal axis is negative. This is the important point. So by that what I say, if I take a convex lens and this is the image, this is the object and here is my image, this height, suppose it is 3 cm, we take this height as positive because you can see this length, this is the principal axis. This line is called the principal axis. Now this length is above the principal axis, that is why it is taken as positive. Now if you consider this length, it is below the principal axis, and that is why if this is say 2 cm, you have to take that as minus. So this length is taken as minus because it is below the principal axis. So basically you have to know these two things, that above the principal axis is taken as positive and below the principal axis is taken as negative. And one more thing I want to add over here, object height is denoted by the letter O. So over here O is equal to say plus 3 cm, or if you write only 3 cm also no problem. And image height is denoted by I, and over there it will be how much? Minus 2 cm, because you can see it is below the principal axis. So over here you have to mention it minus 2 cm. So I hope these 5 points are clear to all of you. So if it is clear, then we will study 2 formulas, and based on these 2 formulas we have the entire sums. Okay, power of lens is there, but we will deal with the power of lens in a separate video. Now, 2 formulas that you have to know for this chapter is the first formula, 1 by F is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. This is called the lens formula. So this is called lens formula. Okay, 1 by F is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. And don't get confused with the mirrored formula. In the mirrored formula, this becomes plus. So this, if it is plus, that is the mirror's formula. Okay, but this is lens formula. So lens formula will have negative. So don't get confused with the mirrored formula. Mirrored formula, the only difference is this is positive. And the second formula you have to know is what? Magnification is equal to image height by object height. Magnification is equal to image height by object height, which is equal to image distance, which is V, by object distance. So image height by object height is equal to image distance by object distance. If you don't need this also, okay, just remember this formula. This is called magnification formula. So basically these two formulas you have to know in this chapter. Now how this formula comes, these derivations are there in your book, but it is not included in your syllabus. And basically I want to keep my video simple. So basically you don't need to know the whole derivation, how this formula comes. Okay, if you want, you can just go through it. You have to make use of similarity of triangles to get to this formula. But basically you don't need to put your head on in this derivations. You just need to know the final formulas of derivations. So these two formulas you have to know for doing the sums. Now based on this, I will do one sum. So based on this formula, see one sum how I am doing it, and you will get an idea or a gist that how these sums are done. So basically we have a sum related to the formulas, and see how to approach the sum. It is very important you should know how to approach the sum, because when your approach is correct, then obviously throughout the whole sum, your answer, you get the correct answer. So basically you have to know how to attack the sum, how to approach the sum. If you happen to know this part, then I can easily say you, the half of the battle is already won. Firstly, you have to know the first part over here, that you have to know over here, is this word, convex. As you read the sum, try to see in the sum, what is my lens? Is it a concave lens or is it a convex lens? As you got the idea, this is a convex lens. Basically, at that point, you draw a lens. You draw the principal axis. You draw the convex lens with the optical center O. Finish. First part is how to, what kind of lens that I am using, you have to know. And as you know the lens, try to represent it diagrammatically, because when you represent the whole sum in a diagrammatical way, it becomes so much easier for anyone to understand. Now next thing that you have to know is object. Now you know, this is very common sense that your object is placed on the left hand side of the mirror. So this is my object, which is placed on the left hand side of the mirror. So object is placed at a distance 24 centimeter in front of the mirror. Very important, distance of 24. Object is placed at a distance 24 centimeter in front of the convex lens. So this object is placed in front. So if this is my lens, this is called the front part of the lens, and this is called the back part of the lens. Now object is placed in front of the lens at a distance of how much? 24 centimeter. So this becomes 24 centimeter. So over there you write U is equal to 24 centimeter. Right? Now also you have to see this distance, that is my object distance. How I am measuring, is that will be positive or that will be negative? And for that I always told you, your principal axis is always in this direction. Okay? And if I'm measuring my object distance, that will be from the optical center to the object. Okay, from the optical center to the object. So as a result, this 24, you can, so this distance you can see opposite to that of the incident ray. This is my incident ray. So my image object distance is opposite to that of incident ray. So as a result, I can say this is how, what this is, minus 24 centimeter. This object distance is negative 24 centimeter because it is opposite. Now, next thing that you have to note is what? My focal length. You can see focal length is 8 centimeter. So as you know, focal length is 8 centimeter. But very important, your focal length is positive or negative. This will be plus 8 or minus 8. See, what kind of lens I have? I have a convex lens. Convex lens, the focal is what? F2. I always stated F2. And if you see the focal length, the focal distance, if I have to measure it, from the optical center to the focus. I have to measure it from the optical center to the focus. And you can see the incident ray and the image distance, this is my the incident ray and my focal length, this are in the same direction. These two are in the same direction. As a result, as they're in the same direction, this focal length will be what? This focal length will be plus 8 centimeter, because I told you incident ray and the distance are in the same direction. Then you have to state that as positive. My focal length is plus 8. So these two part gone. Now next part. What is this for? The object height is 4 centimeter. Object height is 4 centimeter. This height. This height is taken as 4 centimeter. So this height is taken as 4. Now this is above the principal axis or below the principal axis? You can easily see it is above the principal axis. So that will be positive. So I can say object height. Oh, just previous to that, I taught you the how to denote the object height. Object height, you denote that as O is equal to 4 centimeter, right? 4 centimeter. Now, as you got this whole idea, now I can have a little confidence how to approach the sum. See? So what I need to find? I need to find the position of the image. What is the position of the image? Means what? They are asking me to find the value of V. Okay, so first they are asking me to find the value of V. So how will I find the value of V? I will find the value of V by the lens formula, which is 1 by F is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. I'll find the value of V using the lens formula. Now just put the values. F is how much? 1 by 8. V is how much? Which I don't know, keep that as V. And minus U is how much? 24. Minus 24. Very important over here. Don't get confused between this minus sign and this minus sign. Don't say, as I already have a minus sign, I do not need to put this minus sign. If you are doing it something like this, thinking that I already have a minus sign, I will not put this extra minus sign over here, then over there your sum goes wrong. This minus sign is there in the formula. Okay, this minus sign is for the formula. And this minus sign which I'm putting over here, this minus sign is for the sign purpose of sign indication of U. So don't get confused. Having the minus, don't worry, you have to put another minus because your U is minus 24. So as your object distance is negative, so you have to put minus 24 in place of U. Now after this, what I will write? 1 by 8 is equal to 1 by V minus minus positive 1 by 24. Then after that, what I will write over here? Suppose I'm deleting this part. So 1 by 8, this thing 1 by 24 from this side will come this side. So minus 1 by 24 is equal to 1 by V. So 1 by 24 from the right hand side came towards the left hand side. And after that, 24 is the LCM. This becomes 3. this becomes 1. If you further solve it, I have to rub a little bit. If you further solve it, so what you get? 2 by 24 is equal to V. So V becomes 24 by 2, which is equal to 12 centimeter, which is your answer. Now to check whether my answer is correct or wrong, this is my image, sorry, object. And your image will be formed where? Image will be formed on this side. This is your object, this is your image. Now you can say this image distance from here to here, I'll get my image distance as positive or negative. To check your answer, this is the backtracking of answer, okay? To know whether my 12 centimeter is correct or wrong, you have to know this method very well. This image is formed like this. So your image distance is measured from the optical center to the through the point where the image is, and you are measuring it this way. And this is the direction of incident ray. You can see both are in the same direction. As both are in the same direction, you know this distance will come as positive. And also over here, your distance came as positive. You can see it is plus 12. So you are 100% sure that my answer is correct. So this is how you back check your answer. By from the diagram, you can say my image distance will always come as positive because it is with the incident ray. And also I got the image distance as positive. So my answer is correct. So you got the answer V as 12 centimeter. Now what is the second part of the question? The second part of the question is asking about the size of the image. The second part of the question is asking about the size of the image. If they're asking me about the size of the image, I will use this formula. I by O is equal to V by U, means image height by object height is equal to image distance by object distance. Image height by object height is equal to image distance by object distance. I'll use this formula, which I just taught you previously. Now, what is my image height? I don't know because I have to find that only. Keep I as I. What is my object height? Object height is 4. What is the value of V? V, just now I found it. It is 12. And what is the value of U? Very important. U is 24. No, it is minus 24. U is minus 24. Now when you solve it, okay, you get 4 ones are, 4 six are, minus, so it will become, I will become minus 2 centimeter. And this minus 2, you know, why I am getting the answer as minus 2? Because if your image is, object is over here, image will be coming down. Image will be coming like this way. And I know this image height is negative. As you can see, it is below the principal axis. This is below the principal axis. As a result, this will come negative, my image height. And also I got my answer as negative, which gives me a real confidence that yes, my answer of minus 2 centimeter is correct. By this way, you can check your answer in the exam, whether your answer is coming correct or incorrect. Okay, by looking at the sign that my answer came over here as negative. And obviously, it has to come negative because my image height will be, my image is below the principal axis. So you got this answer. Now, the third point is what? State the characteristics of the image. State the characteristics of the image. So, how to state the characteristics of the image? Firstly, with the answers you can say, as you can see a negative sign over here, that means what? Erect or inverted. This means, this negative sign means what? This of the image is like this, not in an erect way, this is an inverted way. So this negative sign indicates what? Is inverted. Now we know every inverted image will be real image. Every inverted image is a real image. Now, third point that I have to know from here. you can see the object is of 4 cm while your image is just 2 cm. So object is 4, quite big, and the image is just 2, small. Means what? The size of the image got diminished. So I'll say state what? It is inverted, real, as well as diminished. So you got the idea that how to do the sum. If you haven't understood, please check the video once more. Please watch this numerical part once more. And I'll give you one sum to do. So this is a sum for you. This is a sum for you. The object of height 4.5 cm is placed at a distance of 15 cm in front of a convex lens of focal length 6 cm. And the same, find the position and the size of the image and state the characteristics. So this is a sum for you. You please try the sum by your own and write the answer in the comment section. If it is correct, I will definitely answer you. And if it is wrong, that time also I will say why it is wrong. So, but you have to try this one sum by yourself. The same question, just I have changed the numbers. Nothing I have done else. So try the sum as I have tried the previous sum. First write the UF and the object height with the correct sign, positive or negative, and try to draw a diagram for that and approach the sum. See, your answer will come correct only. And write your answer in the comment section. So saying this, I'll end my video. Hopefully this video will be useful for you in the next upcoming 2 videos. The next 2 videos that I will do will be based on the purely on the numericals of this chapter. So next 2 videos will be based fully on the numericals that is given in your book. There are, I think, so 10 to 12 numericals I will try to sort out. So next 2 videos are about the numericals. That will be lecture number 8 and 9. This is lecture number 7, 8 and 9. And last lecture will be on the power of the lens. So by that, I'll end my video. So by saying that, always take care of yourself and please stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care.